Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So if you remember, in the last class we discussed about this Hook's law, but I didn't write the statement on the board, okay? So here it is. Within elastic limit, the stress is proportional to strain. I only mentioned that the stress is proportional to strain, but I forgot to mention the condition, okay? This condition is very important. Why is it important? Because if you go beyond the elastic limit, then this law will not be valid anymore. Okay, so within the elastic limit, this law is applicable. If you go beyond the elastic limit, this law is invalid, okay? So if I write it in an equation, stress, proportional sign, strain. Now if I'm to replace this proportional sign with an equal sign, then definitely I have to introduce a constant, okay, as I have done. Then as the strain is multiplied here, if I change the sign, it will be divided. So we will get a ratio of stress and strain, which is constant. Constant means this will not change, okay? Now this constant has been named as modulus of elasticity, or it is said Young's modulus, okay? Okay. Now, the thing that I want to know from you, can you tell me what will be the unit of this Young's modulus? What will be the unit? If you take a look at this equation, this equation actually will tell you what's the unit of Young's modulus. Can you tell me? No? Nobody? Fatima? Akbar? GM?
Yes, sir.
What will be the unit of this Young's modulus? So, we came up to join for sir.
1 minute, sir. 3 minutes.
I'm going to make full explanation. So, Nazmul, Robin, answer for it.
Hey, sir.
What is the unit of this Young's modulus?
What is the unit of
Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity? It is a constant or unit key?
Newton by m.
Newton by meter. Newton per meter.
Yeah.
Why it is Newton per meter? Can you explain?
PA. Pascal.
Now, tell me what is the unit of stress. What is the unit of stress? True. That's going to sound very good.
Modulus
of elasticity. What is the unit of it? The unit of modulus of elasticity is
Newton per meter.
Newton per meter square, okay, because the stress is pressure, right? And what is the unit of a strain? Strain does not have any unit, right? It is unitless. So Newton per meter square divided by nothing, so it will stay on the Newton per meter square, right? So this is the unit of modulus of elasticity. Okay? Finish. Now in page number 150, as you can see, there is an equation written. Okay, I will explain the equation now. So we know that stress is equal to force divided by area. We have considered the force to be T or tension, I will explain in the last class. And strain, what is the strain going to be? Strain, it is equal to L naught divided by L naught. This is the strain. Okay. Now, according to Hook's law, what we can write, T by A is proportional to L minus L naught by L naught. Okay. Now, if I want to replace this proportional sign by an equal sign, I must introduce a constant, and that constant is Y, because the name of this constant is Young's modulus. Okay. Now, this constant has different value for different object. It is constant for a particular object. Let us say, whenever we are doing the experiment, we are not changing the element that we are doing experiment with. Let us say this is food. So, for food, it has a constant value. Okay. So, it is that is 10 gigapascal. It is listed in a table, that is table number 5.02. If you go to the table, you get different values for Young's modulus of different object. Okay. There are a couple of examples. I hope you can go through. Okay. And the last topic that we have is molecular kinetics. Three state of matter, solid liquid gas. This one actually, you know, there is nothing to discuss about it. Okay. You know what is a solid material. Inside the solid material, the particles are tightly bonded with each other. So, there is very less amount of gap between them. And in liquid, they are a little bit, you know, free. Okay. They have some free space. And in gas, what happens? A lot of free spaces are there, right? They don't have any bond with each other. So, they can just be in random motion. Now, molecular kinetic theory is kind of based on this. Okay. So, the point that we are discussing here, I will just tell you the point in short. You can read the paragraph later. Okay. Now, the first point that we want to say in molecular kinetic theory is any substance consists of innumerable number of mini particles, okay? And these particles are not molecules. Yes, every object is consists of a lot of, a huge number of molecules, right? Inside this, a huge number of molecules are there. This is number one. Number two, the molecules are so small that they are considered as points, okay? They are so small, you cannot even see it with your naked eye, okay? You have to see it with microscope, okay? So that is why we consider them to be one point, okay? Number three point, the molecules of a substance are always in motion. Yes, inside this substance, the molecules are always in motion. Sometimes it is in hydrogen motion, sometimes it is in linear motion. Okay, so it is like that. Number four point, the gaseous molecules remain at considerable distance. That means in case of solid, we know there is no gap between them. But in case of liquid, there is a little bit gap. But in case of gas, a huge amount of gap is there between them. Okay, for this reason, almost no force of attraction and repulsion acts between them. True, in case of gaseous substance molecules, there is no attraction and repulsion. They do not attract each other, they do not repel each other. Okay, though the liquid molecules remain at some distance, force of attraction between them prevails. Yes, the liquid molecules also remain at a distance, but that is not like the gaseous case. Okay, so that shows that there is a little bit of force between them, okay? The attraction or repulsion. The last point that we want to discuss here is the molecules that move at a random in liquid and gas. So these molecules collide among themselves and also on the surface of the wall of the container. Right, whenever you keep a certain amount of liquid or gas in a container, what will happen? Inside the liquid or gas, the molecules, they have free space, right? So they will move around, okay? So they will move around and they will get into constant collision with each other, okay? Continuous collision with each other. They will move in this direction, they collide with another, so it will go in another direction, it will collide with another molecule here. And sometimes they will collide with the wall of the container also, right? Okay, I hope this is clear. So these are the points which are actually discussed in this molecular kinetic theory of gas, okay? And then we have the very last topic of this chapter, that is the fourth state of matter. From here, actually, one information is important to know, that is for MCQ. What is the fourth state of matter? Because we already talked about three states, right? Solid, liquid, and gas. What is the fourth state? The fourth state is the plasma state, okay? Here, actually, they did not discuss in much details about this plasma state, okay? So what I'd like to suggest you is, if you're interested to know more about this plasma state, even though that is not necessary for your dissertation study, but if you feel interested, you may take a look in Google or YouTube. You can write plasma state, and several videos will occur. You can just watch them to get a better idea about this plasma state. But for now, for this level of study, we will only get to know, or we will only keep in our mind, that the answer to the fourth state of matter in case of MCQ, it will be plasma, okay? So with that, we have come to an end of our chapter. Already I have actually discussed the important theories with you, so I think this chapter is fully finished, okay? So six chapters we have covered, if you remember, that is motion, force, work power energy, then state of matter, and weight, okay? And another chapter, physical quantity, that is the first chapter, okay? So the rest eight chapters, it will be completed.